The Saturn V rocket, or the rocket that took man to the moon, was at the time the biggest rocket ever constructed by humanity. It was built during the 1960s and could lift the largest payload ever of 41,000 kilograms of cargo and equipment into low Earth orbit. Now, since our sights are set on the moon and eventually Mars, NASA has been developing a new rocket, one that is much more powerful than the Saturn V. It is known as the Space Launch System, or SLS for short, and is the rocket that is planned to take man back to the moon in 2024. Here we will look at the SLS's capabilities and why it has taken so long to be designed and constructed. The Space Launch System is the newest spacecraft that NASA has been developing in conjunction with the Artemis program, in the hopes that it will easily be able to take humanity beyond low Earth orbit. It will be the only rocket capable of carrying humans, as well as landers and habitats, making it ideal for deep space exploration. The SLS will come in three main versions, Block 1, Block 1B, and Block 2. Each version will have a core stage of 65 meters in height and 8.4 meters in diameter, the biggest of any rocket ever. The main core stage can then be broken up into five main sections. The first section is the engine, which is powered by four RS-25 boosters. On launch, these will burn for 500 seconds, bringing the spacecraft to a speed of Mach 23, or around 28,000 kilometers per hour. This part of the rocket will also be responsible for the steering. The next section of the core stage is known as the LH2, or liquid hydrogen tank, and is capable of housing over 2 million liters of liquid hydrogen. This must be stored at a temperature of minus 252 degrees Celsius to maintain the hydrogen's liquid state. The intertank is the next part, which connects the LH2 to the LOX, or liquid oxygen tank. This tank has a capacity of over 740,000 liters of liquid oxygen, but must be kept at a temperature of minus 182 degrees Celsius. The final section is the forward skirt, which houses the avionics, or the brains of the rocket. The core stage can then be fitted with the Orion stage adapter to hold the Orion spacecraft, which will transport humans inside. A cargo adapter with satellites and probes can also be connected to the core stage for deep space transportation. When connecting all of the sections, the core stage can produce 2 million pounds of thrust on launch. There are also two 5-segment support rockets attached to the core stage, which provide additional thrust on launch. These segments are almost identical to the core stage. The boosters have an aft assembly, or engine, however do not have four RS-25 engines that the core stage has. Instead, they have one engine that operates for 2 minutes after launch, each of which provides the rocket with an extra 3.6 million pounds of thrust during this time. The support rockets also have a liquid hydrogen tank, followed by an intertank and liquid oxygen tank, and finally the forward skirt, which houses all the electronics. The final segment of the Space Launch System is the Orion spacecraft attachment to the top of the spacecraft. This is powered by an interim cryogenic propulsion stage, which is a smaller version of the fuel used by the main core of the SLS. Once the Orion spacecraft reaches space, the propulsion stage will activate, sending astronauts to the moon and beyond. By using the solid rocket boosters and the core stage, the SLS can reach space in just 8 minutes. Where most rockets struggle to overcome low Earth orbit, the Space Launch System's Block 1 can reach it with ease, while the SLS Block 1B can reach lunar orbit, and Block 2 will eventually be able to send humans to Mars. The SLS Block 1B makes use of an added exploration upper stage module that is a larger and more powerful version of the interim cryogenic propulsion stage. While the core stage is the same as Block 1, the second stage capsule will have more fuel capacity to reach greater velocities and explore further into space than ever before. The SLS Block 2 has the same core stage as the previous two designs, but instead has more powerful boosters. While Block 1 and 1B produce 8.8 million pounds of thrust, Block 2 can achieve a maximum of 11.9 million pounds of thrust. Block 2 also comes with an increased payload capacity of 150,000 kilograms from the previous 95,000 of Block 1. Unfortunately, Block 1 isn't expected to be flying until June 2020, after it faced a series of problems during construction. The first was financial issues. The Space Launch System isn't small, in fact, it is taller than the Statue of Liberty, or almost 100 meters tall. The project is already costing billions of dollars, with this number expected to increase further for Block 1B and 2. So far, the SLS has already costed $12 billion, and is expected to increase another $8.9 billion in just 2021. Because of these delays, many people are questioning whether the SLS is worth the expense. Though controversy surrounds the rocket, NASA are sticking with their original plan and continuing development. However, if the Space Launch System is built, it will change space exploration forever. It will give us better access to deep space, and will carry humans to our closest planetary neighbours. Already, the Artemis program is being scheduled for 2024, where humanity will return to the moon once again. And with this rocket, the most powerful ever built, we may even be able to set our sights on Mars sooner than you may think. As always, thank you guys for watching the video, and I hope you enjoyed. Remember to subscribe to the channel for more weekly astronomy content, and until next time, goodbye.